Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أما موضوع خطبتنا اليوم As for the title of our khutbah today, brothers and sisters in Islam, ماذا بعد الدنيا? What after this dunya? What is our expectation after our life in this dunya? What is our hope with Allah after we leave this dunya and we go to the next stages of our life? Allow me, brothers and sisters in Islam, to remind you that a human being who is created and lives in this world must pass through these five stages. The first stage is where the human being did not exist. Me and you did not exist. This is Marhalatul Adam. The second stage is the stage that we found ourselves in the wombs of our mothers. This is Marhalatul Wahim. And the third stage is the stage we are in today. Me and you living in this world, being given the opportunity by Allah to worship Him. And this is Marhalatul Dunya. But then, brothers and sisters in Islam, when we die, when we leave this dunya, we will move to the next stage of barzakh. This is the stage we find ourselves in the grave for an appointed time, for a period of time, until Allah proclaims and says, this is the day of resurrection, and that is the final stage, al-akhirah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Qala Allah ta'ala, kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in this ayah, and this ayah is found in Surah Ali Imran, and this is chapter 3, ayah 185. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Every soul, every living creation that was created by Allah shall taste death. There's no exception. Everyone, every human or living thing shall taste death. وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَا أُجُورَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ And you will be rewarded your full compensation on the day of resurrection. فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ And whosoever amongst us on that day, if you are diverted away from entering Jahannam and you are led towards Jannah by the mercy of Allah, then you are the successful one. وَدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ Allah says, وَقَدْ فَازْ You are the one who has ultimate victory on that day and success. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ And this life that we live in today, this life that we enjoy today is nothing but an illusion. It's nothing but an illusion, an imagination in our mind, and it's a temporary enjoyment. My brothers and sisters in Islam, allow me to navigate into the deeper explanation of the ayat that we have just discussed. Allah says, "Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut." Every soul shall test death. Allah Azza wa Jalla issues a general statement. That includes Muslims, non-Muslims, includes every living creation of Allah, that you shall test death. And every living thing on this sense will test death. And in another statement, Allah says in the Holy Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. This is chapter Surah Ar-Rahman, ayah 26 to 27. Allah says, كل من عليها فان Whatsoever is on this earth that was created will perish. Everything will be destroyed on this day. وَيَبَقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ And the only thing that will remain is the face of Allah, your Lord, full of majesty and honor. This will remain forever. Ahbab Rasulullah, the biggest lessons that we should take from this ayat is that Allah alone is the everlasting, the one and only. Allah is Hayyul Qayyum. He is the one that never dies. While the jinn, mankind, angels, and even the angel that carries the arsh of Allah shall perish on this day. Allah is the irresistible one. He is the one and only. He will remain forever and ever, and he will be the last to remain as he was the last. In Surah Al-Hadid, the beginning of the surah, Allah says, "Huwa al-awwal wal-akhir." He is the first and the last. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this ayah should reassure us that every soul that exists today, which is a creation of Allah, shall perish and shall die. And when the time comes in this life, when the time of this life comes to an end, even the sons of Adam will not be allowed to continue as a new generation. The world will have ended, and Allah will command the resurrection to begin, and Allah will come and reward everybody according to their deeds. If you had your deeds that were small or big, minor or major, it doesn't matter, as long as you have it in front of you and Allah is there ready to judge you upon your deeds. Surely Allah will not deal with us unjustly on that day, even by the weight of an atom. And Allah says in the whole Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. And only on this day of the resurrection shall you be rewarded full wages, full recompense. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's take a minute to understand. For those of us who are working, maybe you're driving, maybe you are working in an office, every 2 weeks, every so often you receive a paycheck from your employer. You always look at the paycheck and say, I worked 20 hours, 40 hours, did they pay me enough? Did they pay me full wages? That is not the case with Allah. Allah will pay you on that day your full wages, because Allah is the one who keeps account of your action and deeds while you're in this world. Ibadullah, the question that should remain with us today is that, who amongst us, who is this one that shall gain the ultimate victory in the day of Qiyamah? Who is guaranteed of ultimate victory during the resurrection, when Allah will line up everybody in front of him to judge them according to their deeds? Who will be saved away from Jahannam on this day? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. And whoever is diverted away from Jahannam, the hell of Jahannam, and is led to the gates of paradise, Jannah, he or she is the one who is successful on this day. Brothers and sisters in Islam, allow me to elaborate more on this. Whoever is kept away from the fire and saved from it and entered into paradise, he or she will have achieved the ultimate success with Allah. This also means that even though we enjoy temporary success in this dunya, we have our jobs, we have our promotions at work, we have our families, we have the houses that we're building and buying, we have all the successes that we call worldly success, but the fact and the reality remains, the only success with Allah is the success on the day of Qiyamah, when your a'mal, your iman, your iman and your amal salihah, covered by the rahmah of Allah, shall save you from entering Jahannam and shall eventually become a means for you to enter Jannah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannata wa na'udhu bika minan nar. O Allah, we ask you for Jannah and we seek your protection from Jahannam. Say Ameen. Ahbab Rasulillah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to supplicate in a long dua. And he used to say, Allahumma la taj'al ad-dunya akbar hammina. O Allah, do not make the world, this world that we live in, the biggest of our aims and concerns. You'll find nowadays, human beings in general, their intention, they plan, they say, today I want to make so much money. I want to go on the road, they will see me, I will drive all the way out of state to make money. This is their aim, to make money. This is their aim, to be great in business, in position, in work, in anything they do for the dunya, they want to do it and exceed. And I'm not saying this is bad. A Muslim should be the best in what they do. But remember, this should not be the main aim and concern while you are alive in this world. And the Prophet ﷺ continues and says, ولا مبلغ علمنا. Do not make this world to be the limit of our knowledge. You'll find, mashallah, nowadays people have PhDs, have masters, have engineering, accounting, IT, any position that they spend a lot of time in this world. But if you ask them about ghusl, if you ask them about wudu, if you ask them about Quran, they have no idea. They did not put time in learning about their deen, because that was not their aim and concern. They are more concerned about following what the dunya is telling them to follow, amassing their wealth and increasing every day on their worldly affairs. And this hadith in this dua says, وَلَا مَبَلَغَ عِلْمِنَا. Do not make the knowledge of this world to be the limit of our knowledge, meaning we should strive to have more knowledge in what will take us to akhirah, because that is where we shall live forever and ever. So whatever we need to learn to facilitate our journey to akhirah, that it needs to be our aim and concern while we are alive. The hadith continues and says, وَلَا تُسَلِّطْ عَلَيْنَا بِذُنُوبِنَا مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمُنَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making dua and saying, O Allah, do not empower on us those who will not have mercy upon us. Brothers and sisters in Islam, to elaborate on this example, we see a lot of people, they're not here today for Jumu'ah. They're afraid to ask permission from their job to come for Jumu'ah. This is exactly what the hadith is saying, and many more. Where our employers, who have no mercy upon us based on our deen, we take their word, we don't propagate our deen and tell them it is our duty to go for Jumu'ah. It is our duty to pray the five daily prayers. We stay in meetings, we stay on the road, we don't excuse ourselves to practice our deen. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making dua and against this kind of situation. وَلَا تُسَلِّطْ عَلَيْنَا بِذُنُوبِنَا مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمُنَا. Ikhwat al-Islam, we learn from the above dua that our big concern and aim should be akhirah, because that is our final abode. That is our final return, and we shall return to Allah, and Allah will inform us about everything that we used to do while we are alive in this earth. Ayyuhal Muslimun, yes, we live in this world. Yes, we have a share in this world. And we are not saying that you should not get that good job. I'm not saying you should not get a good house, but do it according to what Allah has prescribed and what Allah has permitted you to enjoy. But the question with us still remains, what is the most important investment in front of Allah that you should give priority to? What should be our aim every day waking up, saying this is what I want to achieve to get me closer to Allah? Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتَ ثَلَاثَةً. Three things shall follow a deceased person to their grave. When you and me die and we are carried on people's shoulder, we're taken to the masajid and we're taken to the gravesite. Three things shall follow you to the grave. The hadith continues, فَيَرْجِعُ اثْنَانِ وَيَبَقَى وَاحِدٌ. Two of the three things shall return back home, and one shall remain with you in the grave. يتبعه أهله وماله وعمله. His family, his wealth, and his deeds shall follow him to the grave. Three things shall surely follow you to the grave. The cars that you drive might be yours, your name on the registration, the kids, the wealth. Everything shall be displayed on that day as they take you to the janazah to the gravesite. But wallahi, there's only one thing that's remain with you in your coffin, in your grave, and that is your a'mal. And the hadith continues and says, فَيَرْجِعُ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَيَبَقَى عَمَلُهُ. His family, his wealth shall return back home. It's not a choice. There's no exception here. Those families, those wealth will not go with you in your grave. Only your deeds shall follow you in your grave. This is a hadith from Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, muttafaqun alayhi. Ikhwatul Islam, no matter how life accepts you, no matter how you feel that you're successful in this dunya, you should not be occupied by it to the extent that you do not worship Allah as He has commanded you. Do not go against the commands of Allah, because if the temporary worldly gains deceives you or keeps you away from Allah, then automatically you shall be regarded as a loser who will regret on the day of Qiyamah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in a surah that we commonly read in the Quran, in our salah, He says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah, He says, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَافُرُ. The competition in increasing your worldly gains and worldly affairs has surely diverted you from the remembrance of Allah. حَتَّى زُرُتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ. Until you visit the grave. And this visit is not you as a visitor with a car you're driving to the grave. No, you will be carried dead to the grave. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Nay, you are going to know. On that day when you're taken to your grave, you shall know. ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Again, nay, you shall come to know. ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Then nay, you are going to know. كَلَّا لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ. Nay, if you only knew with the knowledge of certainty, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمَ. You will surely see the hellfire in front of you. ثُمَّ لَتَرَوُنَّهَا عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ. Then you will surely see this hellfire with the eyes of certainty. عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then you will surely be asked about the many, many ni'mas that you had in this dunya and the favors of Allah upon you. And brothers and sisters, we know what types of ni'mah we are living today with. We have good clothes. We have cars that we parked outside. We have houses that we're going back to. We have families and friends that we go and talk to in the evening. But the biggest ni'mah from Allah is the ni'matul Islam, ni'matul Iman. Being a Muslim, how many people today call themselves atheists, disbelievers? Do you think the end is going to be the same as the end of a person who is a believer? No. So we need to say Alhamdulillah for all this ni'am. Ayyuha al-mu'minun. The disbelievers during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and even today claimed that they will never be resurrected. Allah gives them a response that befits their claim, which is a false claim that they're making. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قُلْ بَلَى وَرَبِّي لَتُبَعَثُنَّ. Tell them, tell the disbelievers, nay, by my Lord, you will for sure be resurrected. It's not if it is a guarantee that they will be resurrected on the day of Qiyamah. ثُمَّ لَتُنَبَّأُنَّ بِمَا عَمِلْتُمْ وَذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Then you shall be informed of all that you used to do and all your deeds, and that to Allah is easy to do.